of the 15th Latin American Congress of Probability and Mathematical Statistics, for all of us known as CLAPM, the most important scientific meeting in the fields of probability and mathematical statistics in Latin America, a meeting to promote and enhance the collaborations of our community within and beyond our region. Allow me to introduce the members of our head table. On behalf of the State of Yucatan Governor, Mauricio Vila Dosal, the Minister of Research, Innovation, and Higher Education, Bernardo Cisneros Buenfil. The Autonomous University of Yucatan Rector, Dr. José de Jesús Williams. Dr. Daniel Hernández Hernández, Chair of CLAPM's Organizing Committee. Dr. Florencia Leonardi, Chair of the Latin American Society of Probability and Mathematical Statistics, SLAPM. And the General Director of CIMAT, the Mathematics Research Center, Dr. Victor Rivero Mercado. We welcome our special guests, Brenda Ruz Duran, Chair of the Education Commission of the City of Mérida, on behalf of its mayor, Renan Barrera. Adolfo Sánchez Valenzuela, Director of CIMAT's office in Mérida. Fernando Ávila Murillo, representing Tequila Sauza. Luis Enrique Nieto Barajas, incoming president of the Mexican Statistical Association. Ramón Peniche Mena, Director of the Mathematics Faculty of the University of Yucatan. María de Los Ángeles Sánchez Contreras, Director of the Mérida's Office of the Center of Research and Assistance in Technology and Design of the State of Jalisco. Victor Manuel Bautista Ancona, Head of the Mathematical Sciences Master's Program at the University of Yucatan. The Polytechnical University of Yucatan's Rector, Gildardo Sánchez González. Ramsés Mena Chávez, outgoing president of the Mexican Statistical Association. Eduardo Francisco Alvarado Mujica, regional president of the Chamber of the Electronics, Telecommunication and Information Technologies Industry. Rafael Pérez Abreu, Director of CIMAT's office in Aguascalientes. And now we will listen to the welcoming message that Claudia Klupperberg, President of the Bernoulli Society for Mathematical Statistics and Probability, has sent for us.
Dear colleagues, estimados colegas, on behalf of the Bernoulli Society, it is my great pleasure to pass on the best wishes and to express my respect and gratitude to the Scientific Program Committee and to the local organizers of this Congress for their excellent work. Many of you will know that there has been a long and fruitful relationship between the Bernoulli Society and the Latin American countries in probability and mathematical statistics. The Congreso Latinoamericano de Probabilidad y Estadística Matemática, or Latin American Congress on Probability and Mathematical Statistics, called CLAPEM, had its inception in the 28th Annual Convention of the Venezuelan Association for the Advancement of Science, organized already in 1978. An invited speaker to this year's Congress, Klaus Krickeberg, at that time he was president of the Bernoulli Society, proposed the formation of a Latin American branch of the Bernoulli Society. That was the outline for the constitution of the regional Bernoulli Society's branch, which is now called the Comité Regional Latinoamericano or Latin American Regional Committee, called LARC. This committee is at present chaired very competently by Florencia Leonardi. Among its founders, it was natural to think of the Bernoulli Society as a means for exchange, collaboration, and cooperation between Latin American probabilists and mathematical statisticians, leading to the general agreement that there should be a regular congress, the CLAPEM. Nowadays, the CLAPEM is considered the most important conference in mathematical statistics and probability for scientists in Latin America. It has proved to be an important event for the promotion and growth of the fields of mathematical statistics and probability in Latin America because of the participation of lecturers and keynote speakers from all over the world. And this Congress bears witness to this. On the other hand, CLAPEM has received many young researchers and graduate students promoting probability and mathematical statistics among the national communities in the countries where it has taken place. I apologize that I cannot attend the CLAPEM in person, but perhaps some of you recognize that I have dressed up for the occasion by wearing one of these wonderful handmade blouses from the Chiapas area, which I visited a long time ago. The CLAPEM series is not the only conference where the Bernoulli Society is involved with. Next year there will be the Bernoulli IMS World Congress in Probability and Statistics in Seoul in South Korea. World Congresses are the largest scientific conferences of the Bernoulli Society. They are run jointly with the IMS. They take place every 4 years and they go around the world. If you plan to organize a conference yourself, then you can also apply for sponsorship of the Bernoulli Society. No money involved, I'm afraid, but your conference is advertised on the Society's webpage, in Bernoulli News, and in the Bernoulli e-briefs, which are sent to every member. There are a few requirements which you find on the Society's webpage. The Bernoulli Society also participates in scientific awards like the Bernoulli Prize, the Ito Prize, the Döblin Prize, and the Ethel-Newbold Prize. For young researchers, there's also the chance to participate in the New Researchers Award and speak in the award session, for instance, in one of our world congresses. Watch out for these opportunities. At this CLAPEM, the Aranda Ordaz Prize recognizes the best PhD thesis in probability and in mathematical statistics by Latin American students. The Bernoulli Society is happy to support this prize conceptually, also financially, and it congratulates the students who will be awarded during this Congress. As you can easily guess, the many activities of the Society cannot happen without the energetic support of its members. The workload, which is quite substantial, is distributed among many of us. You see this at our webpage, where you will recognize probably many names. They all help to promote mathematical statistics and probability theory, and also you are very welcome. To conclude, the Bernoulli Society is very proud of having had a supporting role for the LARC and CLAPEM, where we now experience the 15th Congress. In the name of the Society, I wish you an exciting scientific congress featuring great keynote speakers, invited thematic sessions, short courses, as well as contributed and poster sessions. Cordial greetings or saludos cordiales from the Bernoulli Society.
We are really thankful for the generosity shown by the Autonomous University of Yucatan, in which wonderful central building we are now. Please let me ask the rector, Dr. José de Jesús Williams, to address us with his speech.
Muy buenas tardes, tengan todas y todos ustedes, distinguidos integrantes de la mesa del Presidium. Muchas gracias por su presencia, maestro Bernardo Cisneros Buenfil, secretario de Investigación, Innovación y Educación Superior del Gobierno del Estado, en representación del licenciado Mauricio Vila Dosal, gobernador constitucional del Estado de Yucatán. Muchas gracias por su presencia. Y con ello saludo al doctor Daniel Hernández Hernández, presidente del comité organizador. Muchas gracias, Daniel, por la confianza en la universidad. Y con ello a la profesora Florencia Leonardi, presidenta de la Sociedad Latinoamericana de Probabilidad y Estadística Matemática. Al doctor Víctor Rivero Mercado. Muchas gracias, Víctor, director general del Centro de Investigación en Matemáticas, investigadoras, investigadores de diferentes países que nos acompañan, sean ustedes bienvenidos. Para mí es un honor poder recibirles en el Centro Cultural Universitario de nuestra Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán para celebrar la 15ª edición del Congreso Latinoamericano de Probabilidad Estadística Matemática, que por segunda ocasión se lleva a cabo en suelo mexicano. Esta vez coordinado por el doctor Daniel Hernández del Centro de Investigaciones en Matemáticas y sobre todo articulando los esfuerzos de instituciones académicas como la Universidad Nacional Autónoma de México, la Universidad Autónoma Metropolitana, el Instituto Tecnológico Autónomo de México, la Universidad Juárez Autónoma de Tabasco, la Universidad Autónoma de Chapingo, el Centro de Investigación y de Estudios Avanzados del Instituto Politécnico Nacional y de la Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán, de las asociaciones como la Sociedad Bernoulli para la Estadística, Matemática y Probabilidad, del Instituto de Estadística Matemática de los Estados Unidos, de la Asociación Mexicana de Estadística y de la Sociedad Matemática Mexicana. Y por supuesto, del Gobierno del Estado de Yucatán, a través de la Secretaría de Investigación, Innovación y Educación Superior, y del Consejo Nacional de Ciencia y Tecnología. No hay proyecto complejo que se resista a la suma de esfuerzos de tal cantidad de instituciones involucradas, por lo cual envío mi más sincero agradecimiento al comité organizador, en particular a los profesores de nuestra Facultad de Matemáticas, José Luis Batún, Enrique Pantí y Jorge Argáez, y a Rosy Dávalos del CIMAT, quienes con mucho ánimo trabajaron para que la estancia de cada uno de ustedes sea lo más agradable y enriquecedora. la relevancia e interés que tiene para nuestra universidad la realización de este congreso se pone de manifiesto en nuestra misión, que es la Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán, es una institución pública de educación media superior y superior que promueve oportunidades de aprendizaje para todas y todos a través de una educación humanista, pertinente y de calidad. Contribuye al desarrollo de la ciencia, las humanidades, la tecnología y la innovación, a la atención de problemáticas locales, regionales, nacionales y mundiales, y a mejorar el nivel de bienestar de la sociedad yucateca. Este evento, que es el más grande de la especialidad en Latinoamérica, será el escenario en el que destacados investigadores compartirán sus resultados de investigaciones de frontera del conocimiento, promoviendo oportunidades de aprendizaje que contribuyan al desarrollo de la ciencia, la tecnología, la innovación y también que atienda problemáticas para mejorar el nivel de bienestar. Una rápida revisión al programa nos permite ver las temáticas que se abordarán durante esta semana y muestra a quienes no somos del área de matemáticas que la disciplina es muy amplia, diversificada, en ocasiones abstracta y también aplicada en diferentes áreas, algunas de las cuales tienen impacto en la cuarta revolución industrial. Llamando mi atención, por ejemplo, en el curso de modelado jerárquico bayesiano y análisis por Big Data especial, la conferencia El estudio de criptomonedas usando modelos de series de tiempo y las sesiones relacionadas con modelación estadística con aplicaciones biomédicas. Por mencionar algunos temas de interés para nuestro estado, y también para contribuir a contar con un mejor mundo para vivir. Aunque honestamente, también llamaron mi atención títulos de dos conferencias: El teorema del límite central con una marcha aleatoria del elefante y una hormiga en el laberinto. Algo me dice que ambas tienen un alto contenido de matemáticas muy complicadas para un servidor. Hace 56 años, nuestra universidad fundó el Centro de Estudios Físico-Matemáticos, que hoy es nuestra Facultad de Matemáticas, para promover la afición y el estudio de estas ciencias mediante cursillos, conferencias, publicaciones, así como mejorar la enseñanza, principalmente de las matemáticas, de acuerdo con las corrientes de la didáctica moderna. Y hoy refrenda ese compromiso al ser sede de tan importante congreso en beneficio de nuestra comunidad matemática. En una carta al Bolyai en 1808, Gauss le escribió: "No es el conocimiento, sino el acto de aprender. Y no es la posesión del conocimiento, sino el acto de llegar ahí, lo que otorga el mayor placer". Estoy seguro que durante esta semana encontrarán el mayor placer en la probabilidad y la estadística matemática que los reúne. Les deseo lo mejor y que lo disfruten. Muchas gracias por su atención.
Thank you very much, Dr. Williams. It is now time to ask for the intervention of Dr. Daniel Hernández Hernández as the chair of the organizing committee.
Well, welcome to the 15th Latin American Congress of Probability and Mathematical Statistics. Dear members of the honorary panel, Maestro Bernardo Cisneros, Dr. Jose Jesus Williams, Dr. Florencia Leonardi, thank you very much for being present today and for all your support. Authorities of the University of Yucatan, Licenciado Alberto Barrera, Mayor of the City of Mérida, we receive also his support. And authorities of academic institutions of the state of Yucatan. We are very fortunate to meet here today in such a vibrant city. It is truly a great honor to have you here. I'm here, very happy to see you again after the meeting of San Jose, Costa Rica 3 years ago. The Bernoulli Society and the SLAPM are paramount for the development of our subject matters in our region. I would like to take this opportunity to highlight a few meaningful activities that have been organized since San Jose, such as the Brazilian School of Probability, the School of Information and Randomness in Chile, the Symposium of Statistics in Costa Rica, and the COBAL Conference in Peru, among others. So we now convene here for our special event, the CLAPM. We meet in Mérida at the exciting times for probability and statistics, both in Latin America and elsewhere in the world. They are becoming wide-ranging, challenging, and far-reaching disciplines with implications for an increasing interaction with practically every field of science and multiple organizations dealing with many aspects of life. Data analysis and uncertainty rule the modern world. And this, in turn, poses theoretical and methodological challenges in our field of study as a result of increasing complexity in data structure and the problems being presented. It is because of this great impact that our disciplines have on another science and also on society in general that they carry a great responsibility to perform ethically and accurately. This week, CLAPM will display a broad spectrum of subjects developed in probability and mathematical statistics, a set of plenary speakers, 2 courses, 10 thematic sessions, 10 organized contributed sessions, and 80 contributed works will take place in topics that are in the forefront of theory and practice. The scientific committee made a great effort, and I would like to recognize that, to nominate and attract specialists who will present the new subject matters that are bringing together diverse research groups at the moment. Altogether, the meeting will indeed showcase top quality and relevant work that is being developed in our region, immersed, of course, in a global context. I wish to extend a special welcome to the students in attendance who will become the future of our disciplines. There are 100 students who have registered to participate from 34 different countries. For them, I'm quite certain CLAPM will prove to be instrumental in fostering our discipline and forming bonds that could become the foundation of long-term collaborative work. In particular, the winners of the Francisco Aranda Award represent a new generation of probabilists and statisticians that will lead to the development of these subject matters towards the future. Congratulations to all of you. I wish to thank a great number of people for their hard work in preparation of this Congress, especially the organizing and program committee and the local organizing committee. Needless to say, none of this would be possible without their selfless and dedicated contributions. The fact that this work group involved members of many different institutions was definitely a challenge at first, but it eventually became a great strength because of the many perspectives that each member had to offer. To each one of them, I give a sincere thank you for their contributions for the conception and execution of this event. It is encouraging for our community in Mexico to be, after 30 years, the host of this Congress once again. Since that time in 1919, when Professor Gorostiza and his work team organized that version of CLAPM, our research centers and postgraduate programs that form future specialists in our country have transformed significantly. And because of that, we're particularly excited about this year's event academic meetings as this one do not necessarily yield immediate fruit, but without question, they plant the seeds for ideas, vocational research, and future collaborations. As with any meeting, large or small, there is always substantial, quantifiable, and crucial logistic and administrative assistance happening behind the scenes. Because of this, I wish to thank Rosy Dávalos, who is here. Thank you very much, Rosy, and all the team, all the organizing committee, for tirelessly bearing this most demanding responsibility. Thank you very much. In the name of the entirely of the club and organizing committee, we are also grateful to the government of the state of Yucatan for sponsoring this event and hosting the Congress. The University of Yucatan was graceful in providing this noteworthy venue where we are now, as well as a committed team of faculty and students from the School of Mathematics. Thank you very much to all of them also. We value immensely the 12 plenary speakers and the course instructors for their willingness to travel all the way to Mérida, to share their knowledge, and to interact with the students and faculty attending CLAPEM. We hope our gathering will produce, enhance, and strengthen collaboration networks as a result of participants having common interests and purpose. We also would like to give thanks to the Bernoulli Society. Its president, Claudia Klupperberg, as we hear, has been a great promoter of probability and statistics worldwide, and has always shown a great appreciation for the Latin American region. In particular, she has shown a great interest in restoring the good operation of SLAPEN. Florencia Leonardi, as the president of that society, deserves all our support in her efforts to reorganize SLAPEN as head of the committee. We wish you every possible success. We would like to thank the national institution involved in the organization of under this position to allow the participation of their students and faculty in this event. Some institutions and companies provided funding also. The University of Chapingo, the Institute of Applied Mathematics and Systems, IMAS, the Research Center in Mathematics, Tequila Sauza, thank you, Fernando, for being here. And Google. Well, lastly, I would like to thank all of you, my fellow colleagues, for your presence. Over 200 of you are in attendance, in addition to the students that I already mentioned. All of you are the core of scientific discussion, production, sustainment, and divulgation of knowledge. I genuinely hope that the Congress will prove to be extremely fruitful for all of you in an academic, social, and last but not least, personal level. Without further ado, enjoy the beginning of clapping. Thank you very much.
Please let me introduce now Dr. Victor Rivero Mercado, General Director of CIMAT.
Hi, hello. On behalf of the community of the Centro de Investigación en Matemáticas, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the city of Mérida for the realization of the 15th Latin American Conference on Probability and Mathematical Statistics. As we all know, this conference is relevant for the community of researchers in probability and mathematical statistics because it has been a forum to foster the development and diversification of the topic in the region of Latin America. It is a biannual occasion to meet with friends, not only from the region, but also from other corners in the world. In this occasion, we have the pleasure to receive more than 350 participants from 34 countries. As Daniel told us, nearly 50 institutions in Mexico have been working together to make this edition of the CLAPEN possible. For us in CIMAT, it is an honor to be hosting this conference jointly with the Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán, UADY. Thank you very much. The starting point of this conference and the impact that this will have locally in Mérida and in the region is also the beginning of the celebrations of the 40th anniversary of CIMAT. CIMAT is a research center with more than 120 dynamic researchers and 5 offices in Mexico, the most recent here in Mérida and the first in Guanajuato. We have leading researchers in the topic of the conference, but also in other topics of fundamental mathematics and computer science. We can say, without a fear of being wrong, that CIMAT has also a strong reputation in training students with a very good abilities to pursue research in mathematics career or to work in applying mathematical sciences in industry and the public sector. Actually, I must say that I am very proud to see that many of the speakers in this conference are former or actual students from CIMAT and from other institutions in Mexico. Events like this and the network that we build in this kind of conference have been very important for these students to explore the academic world and continue their career. Recently, this is an advertisement, we created the Mathematical Sciences Semester in Guanajuato, which is an international study abroad program open to students with a strong grounding in mathematics who want to increase their knowledge of data science, modeling, and partial differential equations from a comprehensive, forward-looking, and cutting-edge perspective while acquiring a solid theoretical foundation, as well as exploring the rich culture of Mexico and learning Spanish as they go in the beautiful city of Guanajuato. You can learn more about this program in the stand that is outside and maybe send some of your students to this program. During these years, CIMAT has also built a strong link with the public and private sectors of the country, focusing on projects aimed at contributing to the solution of problems, particularly those related to technological innovation. One popular example is that of the application of statistics to improve the tequila production. Thanks to it, we have tequila all around the world nowadays, and in particular, tonight for the cocktail. Thank you to Tequila Salsa for donating it. Today it is also an occasion to thank the support from the state of Yucatán, thank you, who has been funding several of CIMAT's Mérida's activities, as for instance, this conference, and promoting many collaborations with the local government and industry. With only 6 years since its creation, CIMAT Mérida is becoming an attracting point for mathematics in the southeast of the country. And for that, I would like to thank Adolfo, who has been leading this office and doing such a great work. We would also like to thank our colleagues from the Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán, with whom we have been working for many years, promoting the growth of mathematics in this zone of Mexico. The Mérida office wouldn't make any sense without the link with the Department of Mathematics of the Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán and the Universidad Politécnica de Yucatán. Thank you, Gerardo. Thank you. To finish, I would like to thank all of you for coming here. Some of you are frequent visitors to Mexico and to CIMAT in particular, very good friends of us. Thank you for enriching the program of the conference and for helping us building an international research network. I hope you will enjoy of the wonderful scientific and social program of the conference, and of course, of your time in Mérida, that you will have the time to visit this lovely city and its surrounding area. Thank you very much for your attention.
with thanks to Dr. Rivero for his words. And now the turn comes to listen to Dr. Florencia Leonardi, Chair of the Latin American Society of Probability and Mathematical Statistics.
Hello. I would like to thank on behalf of the Committee of the Latin American Society of Probability and Mathematical Statistics. I would like to thank the organizing committee of CLAPEM, in particular Daniel Hernandez, for coordinating this event. This is the main event in probability and mathematical statistics in the region. This event is promoted by the society and by the Bernoulli Society. So I would like to give you here some information about the Latin American Society of Mathematical of Probability and Mathematical Statistics. We have launched this year a new web page, and we have a campaign to have more members and to promote the activities of the society in the region. So here you can find in this address the web page of the society with some information, and you also have in the material you received in the registration the information about the society and how to be a member. And here is the, okay, this is a screen of the web page. So you can enter here and see the information of the society. Sorry. We also have a new accounts in Twitter and Facebook, so you can follow them. And I also have to thank the organizing committee for promoting all the information of the society in the web. And to be a member of the society, of the Latin American Society of Probability and Statistics, you have two forms to be a member. You can directly send us the form in this page. We have a promotion of free of charge for 2019 and 2020. So please be a member of the society and help us to promote the activities in the region. And you can also choose to be a member, a joint member with the Bernoulli Society by a fee of 24 euros. And you have access also to some publications in the area. And in this case, if you have a Latin American nationality or you reside in a Latin American country, you are also automatically a member of SLAPEM. So as Daniel said, SLAPEM also promotes the Francisco Aranda Ordaz Prize for the best PhD thesis in mathematical statistics and the best PhD thesis in probability. So in a moment, we are going to announce the winners of this prize for the period 2016-2019. And on Friday, we are going to have the conferences of the winners. So you can find in the program the time of these conferences. But first, I would like to invite a colleague of Francisco Aranda Ordaz, Eduardo Gutierrez Peña, to say some words in remembrance of Francisco Aranda Ordaz. So please, Eduardo.
Good afternoon. Francisco Aranda Ordaz was a young and standard Mexican statistician. For about 10 years, he was one of Mexico's leading figures in the Mexican and Latin American statistical communities. mostly due to his work on applied statistics, but also of his keen, because of his keen interest in promoting our discipline and his concern for his students. He did an actuarial science degree in the early 70s and a master's degree in statistics and operations research in the, at the National University of Mexico. He then worked for his PhD under the supervision of Professor Sir David Cox at Imperial College London. He came back to Mexico in 1980 to work at his alma mater. Francisco published over 20 papers on statistics, neurology, and pathology in journals such as Biometrica, Biometrics, and Structural Pathology. He also held positions as visiting professor at the University of Waterloo in Canada, as well as several others in Mexico and Latin America. He was also, if I remember well, one of the organizers of the CLAPEN that was held in Mexico back in 1990. I was fortunate to work with him for a very brief period before he died tragically in 1991. To honor his memory, the Latin American Society for Probability and Mathematical Statistics created this award to recognize the best PhD thesis in probability and mathematical statistics written by a Latin American student. Francisco is still greatly missed. Thank you.
Okay, now, so I would like to invite Pablo Ferrari, that was the chair of the jury of the prize, Francisco Arandardais Prize, to help me to deliver the certificate. So first, I'm going to announce the winners of the prize in statistics. The prize in statistics has been, the jury has decided to give a share prize between two winners. One winner is Leonardo Fabián Moreno Romero with the thesis Estadística para datos en espacios no euclídeos, algunas contribuciones. The Universidad de la República Uruguay, and the advisors are Ricardo Freiman and Fabrizio Gamboa. So please, Leonardo. And this prize in statistics is shared with Maria Antonella Gieco by, with the thesis Dimensión Efectiva en Escenarios de Alta Dimensionalidad from Universidad Nacional del Litoral, Argentina, under the direction of Liliana Forzani and Carlos Tolmaschi. So Antonella couldn't come to CLAPEM, so Ricardo Freiman is going to receive this certificate. Okay, now the prize in probability. First, I would like to announce honorable mention of the jury. It is for Erika Roldán Roa with the thesis Topological, Geometric, and Combinatorial Properties of Random Polyominoes, something like that. Advisors Victor Pérez Abreu and Matthew Kahl. And the prize in probability goes to Abelio Sepúlveda from with the thesis exit set of the continuum Gaussian free field in two dimensions and related questions from ETH Zurich in Switzerland and under the direction of Wendelin Werner. I would like to acknowledge the jury, the chair Pablo Ferrari, and all the professors that contributed with this prize, reading all these theses and doing this great job, and also the winners of the prize. So I invite you, all of you, to the conferences on Friday of the winners, and thank you very much.
Congratulations to all the award winners. The Latin American Congress of Probability and Mathematical Statistics has received an important and enthusiastic support from the state of Yucatan. Please welcome the Minister of Research, Innovation, and Higher Education, Bernardo Cisneros Buenfil, to inaugurate the works of this, the CLAPEMS 15th edition.
Con su permiso, saludo muy cordialmente al doctor José de Jesús Williams, rector de la Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán, siempre extendiendo la mano y siempre es un gran anfitrión. Gracias, como siempre, por su calurosa amistad y siempre buena disposición a colaborar en todos los temas importantes para el Estado de Yucatán. También quiero saludar con mucho gusto al doctor Daniel Hernández, como cabeza o presidente del comité organizador. Me da muchísimo gusto, ha hecho un gran trabajo. La verdad es que por lo menos llevo 13 meses recibiendo llamadas para decirme cómo va el evento y ha sido un gusto trabajar con él. También quiero saludar con mucho gusto al doctor Víctor Rivera, que es el titular del CIMAT, siempre pendiente también de las cosas en Yucatán y qué tanto se va moviendo el tema de matemáticas y buscando siempre también oportunidades de colaboración. Un saludo muy cordial y también, por supuesto, a la profesora Florencia Leonardi. Muchas gracias por estar aquí. Y quiero pues decirle a todos que on behalf of Governor Mauricio Vila, I want to give you the warmest welcome to the city of Mérida, the capital city of the state of Yucatán. I am truly honored to host this 15th Latin American Congress of Probability and Mathematical Statistics. We are really happy to be your host. I also want to say that I am very surprised, truly surprised. I have never seen 250 advanced mathematicians cheering for a tequila producer. And quiero también, por supuesto, empezar por agradecer al CIMAT que escogieron a Mérida, escogieron a Yucatán para ser sede de un evento tan importante como este 15º Congreso Latinoamericano de Probabilidad y Estadística Matemática. No solamente porque es la segunda vez que viene a México, sino también porque la primera vez fue hace 30 años. Y que estén aquí el día de hoy es muy importante para Yucatán. Yucatán, que está haciendo un esfuerzo grande por construir capacidades alrededor del tema de matemáticas. Creemos, estamos seguros que esta es una oportunidad única para presentar a Yucatán como algo más, a diferencia de como comúnmente se le conoce, que tiene una gran historia, tiene una riqueza natural, una riqueza cultural, artística, por supuesto gastronómica. Y creo que es el momento de salir y presentarles que Yucatán también sobresale por muchas otras capacidades. Y quiero empezar por decir que Yucatán es el tercer estado en México con la tasa más alta de matemáticos en el Sistema Nacional de Investigadores por cada 100,000 habitantes. Y ha habido un crecimiento importantísimo, un crecimiento que se ha visto fortalecido por esta relación positiva entre la Universidad Autónoma de Yucatán, que tiene una base extraordinaria de matemáticos, tiene una facultad que dirige con mucho acierto el doctor Peniche, hace extraordinario trabajo, y estos jóvenes egresados se encuentran tanto en el CIMAT como en el IMAS la posibilidad de crecer tremendamente sus capacidades, y esta combinación se está viendo reflejada en este indicador que comento. Y este indicador, pues en realidad nos está empezando a abrir las puertas para muchos sectores que antes no volteaban a ver a Yucatán. Y hoy creo que en esta economía del conocimiento, el hecho de contar con esta base es fundamental. Creo que Yucatán se prepara y se prepara con mucho interés y con mucho trabajo para poder buscar sectores que no solamente estén experimentando alto crecimiento, sino que también sean destino de alto valor agregado. Y creo que este cuadrante es sin duda un espacio importante para que Yucatán haga esfuerzos para la atracción de inversiones. Estamos muy contentos de recibir este evento. También quiero decir que felicito, a lo mejor un poco anticipadamente, al CIMAT, pero prácticamente cumplen 40 años en el mes de abril, y ese es un largo trecho, un largo camino en la generación de mexicanos con todo este tipo de capacidades que son tan importantes para el desarrollo económico de nuestro país. Quiero comentarles que gracias a todos estos indicadores se me han ido abriendo puertas en diversos sectores que no consideraban a Yucatán. Puedo comentar que estuve en un evento de microfinancieras en la capital del país, donde al presentarles una serie de estadísticas y estas combinaciones que tenemos, no solamente de la UADY, el CIMAT, el IMAS, el Centro GEO, la UPI, voltearon a ver a Yucatán, y hoy puedo decirles que tenemos el interés de la banca de desarrollo, no solamente de FIRA, sino también de NAFIN y también de la Sociedad Nacional Hipotecaria, por tratar de desarrollar junto con ellos una serie de iniciativas que puedan aprovechar todo el tema de la ciencia de datos y, por supuesto, la inteligencia artificial. Y creo que estas oportunidades son muy valiosas para el estado de Yucatán, y seguramente con todas estas capacidades que se desarrollan podremos responder puntualmente a los retos que se presentan. Quiero también decir que no solamente se nos ha considerado para este tema de la banca de desarrollo, sino que también hay una iniciativa que empieza a gestarse en el que se habla de la inteligencia artificial para el cambio climático. Y también allá se le está considerando a Yucatán con las capacidades importantes para poder sobresalir en este tema. Así que, como podrán ver, yo estoy muy contento de que ustedes todos nos visiten, de que todos ustedes se enteren de que existen esas capacidades, de que todos son bienvenidos, de que nos interesa que estrechen los lazos, que por favor busquen siempre algún tipo de relación productiva aquí con todos los investigadores que tenemos, que sin duda alguna tienen mucho que aportar, tienen mucho que decir, tienen mucho por hacer para Yucatán y, por supuesto, para el tema de las matemáticas. Quiero también decir que este tema de inteligencia artificial, pues hoy, ¿verdad?, es una tremenda oportunidad de crecimiento. Hoy estamos hablando con esta banca de desarrollo de la posibilidad de montar aquí, pues, todo lo que sería una operación para la interpretación de las diferentes imágenes satelitales y poder encontrar pues diferentes orientaciones e información valiosa para la mejor toma de decisiones. Así que quiero decirles que estamos en verdad honrados con su presencia, con que esta 15ª edición del Congreso Latinoamericano se lleve a cabo aquí en Mérida, Yucatán. Espero que tengan a lo largo de estos días una agenda rica, una agenda que les rete, una agenda que les haga pensar y que también tengan ustedes el tiempo para reconocer en Yucatán un espacio, una plataforma de capacidades que les aprecia, que les espera y que busca con ustedes hacer crecer estas capacidades con las que cuenta el día de hoy el Estado. Sin más, pues quisiera pedirle a todos que se pongan de pie para formalmente declarar que hoy, siendo las 18:05, declaro formalmente ignorado el 15º Congreso Latinoamericano de Probabilidad y Estadística Matemática, CLAPEM 2019. Que todos tengan una extraordinaria jornada y que aprovechen lo máximo la oportunidad de convivir entre tal grupo tan selecto, con tantas capacidades y sin duda alguna, en un ambiente de trabajo y de logro. Muchas felicidades a todos.
Thank you very much, Mr. Secretary. Well, this would be all for today. We wish you the best of congresses, and we will be waiting in the central courtyard for the welcoming cocktail. Thank you very much. Good night.